joined today by John Robertson, Managing Director and CEO of Global Real Estate Securities with REEF. John, can you tell us a little bit about how you think the U.S. REIT industry has handled its liquidity issues and how it's positioned for the looming debt maturities?
Well, I think they've addressed them reasonably well. If you ask most REIT executives in the U.S., they'd say they've got their arms around it pretty well. But it's a matter of reference, though. If you look around the world, a lot of investors look at the U.S. and some of the European markets where debt to assets are in the 50% range, and they say, when are you Americans going to de-gear your balance sheets? And we say, well, we have. And there's billions since sitting in cash ready to spend. But by contrast, there are a number of markets where debt to assets are easily in the 40s. And when you get to Asia Pac, including Australia, debt to assets are in the 30% range, and some companies are in the 20% range. They have much lower appetite for debt over there. So while I would say that it's comfortable, if we went backward from here in terms of liquidity in the debt markets, you could find companies who find themselves a little bit nervous again.
Is there more of this for 2010?
Oh, it depends on where the pricing on the credit markets are. You know, there was a rush when the pricing got to be really, really attractive. I think there is some fear that the reference rates, that is the treasuries, back up. There is room for spread compression, though. I think when you look at where REIT debt has been priced relative to its broader comparably rated peers, it's trading a little bit wide, a little bit cheaply relative to where its competitive set has been. So there is room for REIT debt to actually have spreads compress a little bit further while treasuries perhaps widen out, so the coupons might not change. So there is a decent window, and you are seeing companies issue debt here. But that window could close, and I think companies would do well to raise as much debt as they can while the windows are open.
And if reacquisition was the main theme of 2009, what do you think will be the big trend for 2010?
There is distress coming. There will be banks who are able to push their problems down the road, and they'll be able to work out arrangements. But it's going to take longer, and it's going to be dirtier than a lot of companies are hoping for. And in the end, some of the public companies probably won't have the patience, and their investors won't have the patience, and they're going to feel the need to do something with the capital that they have, the balance sheets that they have. Some companies will probably do dumb things. Some will do really smart things. The great companies themselves will find the really unique deals or the deals that aren't widely marketed, or find a backdoor way into something that they can acquire below value.
John, thank you very much. For REIT.com, I'm Matt Bichard.